pleasure to speak today at the plenary session of the Parliament in Montenegro. Initially, I would like to express my immense gratitude to the President of the Council, His Excellency Mr. Algernon, for his kind invitation, and the President of the Parliament, including all distinguished representatives of Montenegro Republic, for their generosity in organizing this special event in their fascinating country. Taking into consideration the current challenges such as religious extremism, ethnic conflicts, and climate change, I really appreciate the vision the Council emphasized as an international platform to make the world a better and more peaceful place for all of us. Especially the issue of climate change has profound implications for international peace. It leads to the collapse of food production, fresh water, habitable temperature, and ocean food chains that gives us security and therefore exacerbates the risk of conflict. Looking at the topic of peace from the perspective of Azerbaijan, I would like to specially emphasize that the occupation of our internationally recognized territories by Armenia has definitely prevented the assurance of peace and security in the region since the beginning of the 1990s. To bring about peace to the region, Azerbaijan implemented 4 UN Security Council resolutions adopted in 1993 and liberated its internationally recognized territory last year. After the liberation of Karabakh, Azerbaijan has launched many infrastructure projects for rebuilding cities, towns, and nature destructed by Armenians. For instance, we are currently carrying out the environmental friendly smart village project, the Big Three Road project, together with the construction of new international airports, hydroelectric power stations, and utilities in order to secure peace and stability in the region. I assure you that the opening of the Dengizer corridor will also prevent any potential war in the future by strengthening economic ties between the countries. Furthermore, I highlight the fact that the liberated areas are full of anti-tank and anti-personnel mines. It has caused the death and injury of more than 120 Azerbaijani citizens, including 2 journalists, since the signing of the trilateral declaration. Foreign nationals, international journalists operating in the Karabakh region may also suffer from the mine problem. I firmly believe that the Council will stimulate the peace process in the South Caucasus by contributing to the solution of peace-related problems. To sum up, peace cannot be kept by force. It can only be achieved by understanding. Therefore, I'm assured that the Council will successfully promote the understanding of peace, contribute to the mitigation of climate change, and bring about peace to the world. Thank you for your attention.